Warning, we are not experts in any of the topics discussed. Our opinions and discussions are meant for entertainment purposes only. Please do not take any of our words as fact. We do not condone the abuse of drugs, addiction, or the illegal use of drugs. Please zoot responsibly.
If we're now in the episode, are we in the
I
episode?
think we're in it right now.
Oh my God. Help! Help!
No, Troy, we're supposed to be here.
Oh, okay.
We're in the
Dude,
episode.
I feel like if somebody was watching that and they were like I feel like if somebody was watching that and they saw that they were like really high or something, they'd be like, what the fuck?
They're stuck in my phone.
Okay, but I'm gonna change real quick. I'm doing something. I bought something from somewhere. But I'm gonna change real quick so I can do that. As I guess you guys would know, this is the America episode. God bless. So I decided to get some American gear, except I didn't, baby. Texas all the way. The real America. And I got my Budweiser hat.
Oh my God.
Because, well, I don't know, we drink beer or something.
Yeah.
But yeah, I bought this from Walmart today, and I was going there because I was like, yeah, we're in the America episode, but I went to Walmart, and I couldn't find any American stuff. Like, what's up with that? I feel like
that's so weird.
I feel like Walmart always has like American gear.
You would think so. Like, because like
but,
tourists go to Walmart.
Yeah.
So
but this is the only thing I could find. So
I
was like,
dude,
this is
Texas shirt, but not an
Texas
America
beer.
shirt.
And I'm in Florida. It's like, what the
Oh my
fuck are they,
God.
why are they selling this? And then,
Oh my
I don't know,
God.
the Budweiser cap was just, I don't know, I was like, that's
I mean,
kind of American.
Wait, is Budweiser an American beer?
look it up, somebody check that.
Oh,
Just fact check that.
Fact checker. It is an American beer.
Oh, let's go.
I believe. Yeah, Missouri. Okay. Yeah, it's an American beer. Good.
So, okay. So I got something right.
Yeah. Anyway, welcome to Exploring the Zoot Zone, the podcast where two stoners explore the most deepest secrets of the universe and life itself. I'm Alex.
I'm Troy.
And yeah, welcome to this week's episode. It is the American history episode. But
yeah,
yeah.
We're trying something out. I don't know. Obviously, there's a lot to talk about, you know?
Yeah, there is.
So
we
why
have
don't we start with something that we kind of know? I mean, we learned
yeah.
about American
well,
history
it's,
in school.
It's weird that you say that, like, it's been a long history, but America is like one of the youngest countries, relatively.
Yeah, I guess you're right. It founded. I mean, if we're not talking about if we're talking about the United States of America,
yeah,
then I would say that. But the Native American, like,
yeah, well, right.
They've been there for a lot longer,
right?
But I guess we're gonna do United States.
Yes,
history.
That is American history, yeah.
Yeah, that is American history. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, no, but like, I mean, Native Americans, like, that's a part of the
Right. That is
American history.
That is a very big part.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll talk about everything, so stay tuned.
We're gonna talk about everything.
We're gonna go into everything. This is gonna be a multi-day video, so I hope you guys are ready. Get your snacks.
We're gonna go through a whole college course of U.S. history.
Okay, maybe not everything. We're gonna Okay. I have some point.
Yeah.
I brought I don't know. I got some stuff that I wanted
Sure.
to talk about.
Yeah, go ahead.
And but I mean, just to preface why I don't know if people know why I like Texas or like I have my Dallas Cowboys cup, but I was originally born in Dallas, Texas, so that's why I like Texas so much. And I believe that it's the true state of America.
Oh my
I don't know if that is that too political to
God.
say. Is that like illegal?
You just So you're saying that if Texas like rebelled, you would fight with Texas?
Like if I think I get drafted, right? Because I was born there. Like it's like an in reinstated.
You think they would draft you?
Yeah, they would draft specifically me, Alex. I don't know if I would fight for them, but I would maybe work over there. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah.
I think I might get a lot of benefits and like pay would be pretty good.
Okay, but what if they lose?
Then I mean, I they're not gonna America isn't gonna kill me. Like, what are they gonna do?
Yeah, but what if like you're like charged for like working for the enemy?
Oh. Well, I mean, you're assuming that Texas is gonna lose, which is just, do you see an L in this? Is there any L in this fucking name, dude? No. Tejas. It also looks backward on my end,
It
so.
looks good on my end. I hope it comes out okay. If
It
not,
probably
Ian can
will.
flip your video.
Yeah, that's true.
Cause if either of our videos are flipped, I feel like our shirts just don't work.
Yeah.
Okay, so American history, if you had to pick a period of American history to live in, which time period would you live in? And you can't say the present.
Okay, so it has to be
Like
anything.
history.
And this can be like the 20th century to
Yeah.
back then.
To all
I
the
mean,
way
not,
to
to be honest. Oh man. I mean, I can't imagine being anywhere further back than like 1950. I feel
Okay.
like I don't know. I feel like I just couldn't do that, especially 'cause I feel like a lot of technology is just so it's just not there. I mean,
Right.
like when did they invent air conditioning? 'Cause
American,
if I have to
oh,
live in
wow.
Florida, then I'm not.
That's a really good point that I wouldn't have even thought about.
1902, actually. Wow.
Oh, but like, it was probably
Okay.
really bad.
Yeah.
Like, the first one probably didn't do much, really,
Right.
but, you
That's why
know.
I'm surprised people even like moved to Florida like at all or like survived in this climate.
Oh, like before AC?
Yeah,
I
like
mean, people were just used to living in
I
like
guess
the heat.
people were tougher
Like
back
people just
then, you
lived in
know?
deserts too.
That is true. I mean, if it was like that where I went back and I didn't really know that I got traveled back into time.
Okay, yeah. Like
Then I
you
would
wouldn't know what you're
maybe,
missing out on.
right. I'd probably be in like the 20s because I feel like they were having a good
Twenties.
time.
Roaring
The
20s.
roaring
Yep,
20s, baby.
that was my
That's
answer
what.
too.
Oh, okay, really? Yeah,
That
I
was a
mean, I
good
guess that
time.
makes sense. I also want to go back if I could. I would want to go back and see the Boston Tea Party. Like, I want to see that live or join in, to be
You would
honest.
to join in?
Yeah, 'cause I actually recently went to Boston.
Okay, and you thought about doing that.
Well, they had like a little exhibit thing. Like they had like a ship in like the bay or whatever, or like the thing, and then they had people throw tea. Like you could pay and you could go and throw tea off of the
Really?
ship. Yeah, but it was like really shitty.
Oh, it was a tourist
I
trap.
was like. Yeah, it was like a really bad tourist
Oh.
trap. And I was like, this makes the Boston Tea Party seem so lame. And I'm like, I'm sure it was way. I mean, honestly, wait, how cool would the Boston Tea Party do? 'Cause they're just throwing boxes in the
I just
water.
watched like the gears turn in your head. You just made the realization that it was just a bunch of dudes that broke onto a ship and then threw the tea off off the
And
edge.
probably most people were just kind of pissed because they're like, well, that was our shipment. Like, you know how long it takes to get that tea here. It takes months. We're not gonna have any tea, dude. Like, what the hell?
They were probably like, yeah, I mean, there were probably a lot of loyalists back then.
Like, too. those stamps weren't, like, that bad. Like, paying for the stamps. Man, like,
we know Troy would have been a loyalist.
I'm just a realist. I feel like I'd be pissed if I was working on there.
So would you want to go back to the Boston Tea Party?
Well, I mean, now I kind of feel like I'm obligated to.
Would you go and, like, talk to them about it?
Yeah, I probably would. I'd probably join in just because I'd want to see, you know.
What if you were the one guy that got caught?
Like me, present me? Or like...
Yeah. Like, you go back, you, like, try to join in, you can't even, like, get the barrel over, like, over to the edge. And then, like, they run, and then the fucking British get you.
Bro, that would be so bad. I don't even know if people got caught for that.
I don't know.
I think it was just, like, a thing that just happened, and they were like, wow, they just threw all the fucking tea in the river, and they got the actual tea spread to Great Britain or whatever, to England, and they were like, wait, they're throwing the tea in the fucking... They're wasting our tea? What the hell? I mean, talk about L's. England.
Yeah.
Great Britain.
they've taken a lot of L's over the course of history.
But
the Revolutionary War was a big one.
That was a pretty big L, I would say. Maybe one of the biggest L's in history.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe not.
I mean, I think it's up there. Like, you lost to this, like,
colonies that you set up.
And then
that is pretty.
And then you watch as this little country grows to become a global superpower.
Yeah, that's gotta feel bad for them.
Yeah. Moon landing.
Ooh, that's pretty recent.
That is relatively recent, but it is history, and we won, baby.
It is history. I love the people who, like, I mean, this is just a theory, but, like, people say that it wasn't real, like, they put it in Hollywood, like, Hollywood somehow did it. And it's like, there was a funny thing I saw online that was a quote that was like, yeah, because, like, they were saying, like, even if they tried to do it, Hollywood in the time period that they did it, it's hard for them to do it now, let alone the capability of what people had back then, right?
I see.
So it's like, So the Hollywood, the directors were like, yeah, it's too hard to try to do this offsite. So we're gonna shoot on site. So they shot on site on the moon. But it was still faked
on
the moon.
It was faked, but it was on the moon.
They shot it with the green screens on it.
The moon is actually made of cheese. They just put green screens over it so they could show what it actually looked like.
Man, I want to go to the moon.
The moon would be really cool to go to. Like, just like the gravity.
Yeah. Well, and also just looking. Like, like looking up and seeing the Earth. It's gonna look so cool.
I hope we go to space, like, in our lifetime.
Yeah. I'm thinking we might be able to.
Yeah.
With how technology is advancing. That's another thing about, like, at least that, because we are talking about American history, which is technically, we are in it. Like, we're currently experiencing it. You know?
That is true.
Right?
That is, like, the most broad sense of the word history.
Right.
Because we are always technically in history.
Yeah, I mean, that is... It is true, and I feel like we're in a pretty cool, like, interesting... It's very chaotic, I feel like, the history right now in America, which is 2023. What is the date? April 15th.
April 15th, 2023.
Pretty chaotic right now.
Yeah, it's...
not really in a good spot, it feels like, but I feel like there could be recency bias, you know? I'm here, so I feel like it's pretty interesting.
Yeah, but I think we're in a relatively stable time in history relative to the other times. I think there's a lot of... Well, we did just... But, like, I think there's a lot of historical events happening. I was gonna say we had a global pandemic, but I feel like that's happened before, has it not?
Yeah, it has. It also happened in the 20s.
Yeah. So, like, yeah, that's, like, so I'm trying to think of, 1920s. Like, historical moments. But the thing is like, after, once, like, you introduced, like, you know, mutually assured destruction, like,
it's, yeah, it's
nothing can really happen anymore.
Yeah, exactly. They can be, I feel like, you know, like, small skirmishes or whatever, yeah. But... yeah, nothing to the degree of, like, the world wars. Those were insane.
Like, I'd say, that's like, wartime is the most chaotic time.
Yeah, the actual world wars, is that history is actually insane.
Yeah.
Like,
but, like, American history, America didn't even go into World War II until pretty late.
It was until Pearl Harbor.
Until Pearl Harbor, which, yeah, that was, like, yeah.
It was pretty late in the war. It was pretty late into the war. They joined, I think, yeah.
That kind of, like, led to another kind of, like, industrial revolution.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of America started pumping out. And also, I feel like it also helped start, like, our military power and stuff like that. I feel like they ended up just focusing on military and just, they kept going with it and, like, arms dealing and stuff like that.
That's true.
Speaking of Pearl Harbor, 9/11...
That is history.
That is American history. That's probably one of the biggest things in history, at least that we learn in school here, is that 9/11 was the biggest tragedy of all time.
Pretty much.
At least in the, like, American, you know, like, mm-hmm. that's what they teach.
Did you do, like, moment of silence at school?
We did. Yep. We did. And that was up until, like, 2015, I feel like we kept doing that. Or, like, 2014. Yeah, we stopped in, like, 2000. It had to have been, like, 2015, I think we stopped doing it.
I feel like I remember just doing it all the way through.
That's wild. Because, like, it happened in 2001.
Yeah.
And, I mean, like, the impact or, like, the lasting, like...
Yeah, the TSA.
Right.
Exists because of that.
Yeah, that was a pretty wild event. I mean, the entire, like, thing of it.
It launched about. Like, are they wars in like Iraq and
in the Middle East? They basically a war on terror, the war on terror.
No, yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah, we're also just recently feeling the impacts of how just not economically great that incursion went, or like war on terror, and it was basically just a giant failed just thing, because it really didn't amount to much. It was just a bad overall, I feel like.
Yeah,
but that's interesting. There's a lot of stuff to talk about. I mean, let me see what I got. I wrote down some notes and stuff. First of all, how are you feeling? Like,
I've been suited for a while.
You've been suited. I don't think I'm there yet. I'm only at like a 6 or a 5, I think.
Okay.
I'm not really feeling it yet. But, I mean, you saw the cogs turning. Maybe that's just because I'm, maybe it's because I'm just an actual, oh, dude, if we're talking about the 9/11, never forget the Alamo.
Okay.
Everybody.
Okay, Texas.
It's, honestly, if I was going to rate tragedies, the Alamo beats 9/11 every time.
You were saying that on camera.
Hey, that's just my opinion. I can have an opinion on things.
Yeah, that's true.
Can I not?
I mean, your employer is.
I was born. yeah. I mean, that's true. Look, this is all for jokes and fun. Is why we're talking about this.
My God.
But the Alamo is a pretty funny part of history too.
You just said it was funny.
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm joking. I'm being sarcastic. I don't actually think the Alamo is the biggest tragedy of all time. But so basically, do you even know what the Alamo is?
Like, wasn't it? Okay.
Do you remember the Alamo, Alex?
It's, gosh, here we go. All right. It was a bunch of Texans, and that was where they made their last stand
mm-hmm.
against Mexico?
Yep.
They lost.
Yes. They got absolute. It was like, I think the like total was like 1,000 or so. Or maybe it was like, it was a lot of Mexican troops. Like probably like 1,000 or like 10,000. I can't remember what it was.
How many Texans were there?
There was like 12 guys. Like actually 12 guys in like a little hut. Like it was like the smallest fortress, and they made their last stand. And one of those people was Davy Crockett. He's like the famous guy in the Alamo because he was the guy who was the last one to not retreat. It was just him.
Oh, they retreated
against. Yeah, a lot of them like, well, people would retreat.
Is it a retreat if there's 12 dudes? It's like one, yeah, two went home.
Well, basically, it was like they made their holdout, and on top of it, or whatever. I think it was like they were shooting from the top, or whatever. And then, most of the people, except for Davy Crockett, went into the building to hide, or like go in there and like basically wait out or whatever. But he was like he just basically was up there until the end. You know, he made his like shootout stand. I mean, it's just such a funny thing to bring up. I don't even know how they documented it or like realized that it happened.
Do you think they like exaggerated like the numbers?
Probably.
Or do you think like they actually sent like 1,000 troops?
I mean, I think there was a whole like movie. If you go to the Alamo, you can actually like go inside, and then they have some like dioramas of like the battle. Or whatever.
Okay.
And they have like a movie about it. Honestly, I don't really remember it that well.
You don't remember the Alamo movie?
I can't say that. I'm a Texan. I'll never forget the Alamo.
So the Alamo is like a very famous event.
It was, oh my God. It was somewhere about 1,800 to 6,000 men of Mexican troops.
That's a really big range, but the minimum is 1,800. How many and how many Texans?
200.
Okay, so it's not
200.
Okay, that's not like as bad as 12.
Well, yeah, but still, like, that's a big, that's a wide margin.
That is no, yeah, they're like hopelessly outnumbered.
Yeah, but they had Davy Crockett.
They did, which I mean, he was the last one.
If you look up his Wikipedia on like how he died, it says he was violently killed. At the Alamo.
It said violently?
Yeah, it does. I don't know why.
Why does it say that on Wikipedia?
I have no idea. Oh, if you look up how was Davy Crockett killed. Oh my God, how was he killed? He says a soldier killed Davy Crockett with a single bayonet thrust to the heart. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Apparently there was a child survivor of the Alamo that said Davy Crockett fought to his last breath.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Went to Valhalla.
Yeah, he definitely did. To Texas.
Texan Valhalla.
Yeah, Texan Valhalla.
Going back to the moon landing.
Okay.
I was reading a thing, and in the Apollo 10 mission, when they were in, like, the capsule, like, the space capsule, a literal turd started floating around the pod.
No way.
And they had to try to catch it.
No. In like a little baggie.
Yeah, I don't know. And then and like on the transcript of like the radio or whatever, you can hear them
they got a transcript of each other. Oh my God. That's so funny. That's also what I want to kind of go to space, you know? Cuz it's like it's kind of just fuck around with stuff.
Yeah, zero gravity would be crazy.
We can only hope.
If you could replace one person in American history, who would you replace?
Okay. What do you mean replace? What do
like I, you, I you replace? Immediately like go oh, take I'm their place. Them? Yes.
Man, most of the people that I know in history, or at least American history, usually don't end well. I feel like, but that's why they're famous, you know? I mean, I guess it would be, I mean, you heard of Davy Crockett? You heard what happened to him?
Would you pick Davy Crockett?
No, I wouldn't. I would not pick Davy Crockett. I'm trying to think. I don't know if I would want to be like a president or something like that. I feel like that's too much responsibility.
Yeah, that's true.
And like, anything to do with like war, I probably wouldn't really want to do either. I wouldn't really want to experience any of that. So I feel like it has to be something like maybe some like innovator or something, like an inventor.
Ooh, okay.
Because I feel like if I could replace them, I would know
how to do it.
Future technology. So that means that I know how to make everything. If I could bring my, do I get to bring my like phone with me?
No, you don't get to bring your fucking phone.
Why not? Then what am I going to do? I'm going to replace somebody and I'm going to be an idiot. I'm going to doom America.
What if you just basically live through their life?
Oh, okay. Then I'd want to be like, honestly, one of the people I'd want to know what their whole experience was Nikola Tesla.
Okay. Is he American?
I don't think he is, but he is a part of American history.
Yeah, though. He like it was so I feel like Edison's rival.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a lot of like the technology that he developed, I think got like lost or something. I don't really know. There's a lot of mystery to like him and his
yeah,
all of his stuff. Cuz he used to do these things. They were like fairs, but they would build like these crazy like sculptures and stuff like that. It would be like popping up. I can't remember what it was called. It was in 1893. There was something called Chicago's World Fair, which basically showed the City of Light, which is what it was called. And it basically was, he had like AC power and he had like electricity where he actually like had lit up this entire like millions of like light bulbs and what? Stuff like that. Yeah, and it's like, how did he do that in 1893? Like, with like, very minimal technology. Like, the actual, like, ability to... The amount of output that he did
mm-hmm.
would have required so much energy yeah. like that nowadays.
It's like, the old light bulbs would be, like, way more inefficient.
Yeah, and somehow he was able to light up an entire, like, cityscape that they had just built, like propped up.
Oh my god.
It's really, there's not really a good explanation for it.
Yeah.
Like not a really good history of in like written history about it. Which is kind of crazy.
Yeah, I think he was a wizard.
You think he was a wizard?
Yeah. I think that's the only explanation.
Yeah.
Magic. Or a time traveler. I've heard that people theorize that he's a time traveler.
I could imagine that too. He must have brought something back. If he was a time traveler, he probably brought like some crazy battery that he just plugs in
yeah.
to one output. And
if I were him, I would have brought a phone.
Yeah, yeah.
That's actually yeah, a phone would be worthless.
No, it wouldn't. I mean, yeah. Yeah. No.
What are you going to do?
Because to be honest, you have to think.
There's no internet. There's no the signal. Phone,
I was going to say, I was like, well, I can just... Even I, that was the first thing I thought of was, oh, there'd be no signal. You know, there'd be no internet. But what if I took pictures and had them on the phone, right? So I have... But then it's like, well, how am I going to charge the phone? Because after
what Tesla was 9 hours... He's trying to charge his phone.
He had to set up 500 light bulbs and... AC generators.
Do you think he ever charged his phone?
No, probably not. And that's why he probably never ended up getting anything else after that, because he was just an idiot time traveler.
He needed his phone to time travel back. Okay, we solved the mystery.
This is really deviating from actual American history.
It's still technically American history.
Technically it is, yeah.
It's just fictional. Unless it's real.
Fictional, which we can riff. I mean, we do have a disclaimer, right?
Yeah.
Something that I had experienced, not really, it's not really a history as in like of people, mm-hmm. you know, history, but it's nature history. Mm-hmm. I actually recently went to Yellowstone. The giant volcano, like underground volcano thing that's in Montana. And that had so much crazy, like history stuff, like just random like events and things that they had, documented.
Mm-hmm.
It's so crazy. Like, I think one of the funniest things, at least to think about, is that when they first got to Yellowstone, right? There's just all of those geysers and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Like, just there. Yeah. Right? They go there and they're like, what the hell?
Oh, so crazy.
And obviously, if you saw that, you were like, dude, I want to go there, right?
Yeah.
You, like, want to go and get close to it.
Oh, God.
And a lot of people would, like, explorers would go and they would step and they would fall into the geysers because it would crack and break in. And they would literally be boiled alive because they would just dunk them in there. And then, you know, you really can't get out at that point because you're just like, it's so hot. And like,
holy shit.
Yeah. Like, it's so messed up. Like, it's like an actual trap like, for that. But I bet they found out pretty quickly. Like,
oh, yeah, they like spread the word. Yeah.
Right.
But, okay. Is Yellowstone also the place that has like the acid pools?
Yeah, they have. I think they have those as well. I don't know if we saw them, but we saw mostly just the geysers and yeah, and I think they do have those like they're like acidic pools or whatever.
Like they'll actually just like melt you.
I think their like pH is just like insanely high, but I don't know if they'll like melt you. I think it's just kind of the same heat.
Whatever, okay, yeah.
I think, but I could be lying. But
if I could time travel, I would go back in time to before they got to Yellowstone. I'd go to Yellowstone and build railings around the geysers and the acid pools.
Well, that was the thing, though, that was also crazy, was that a lot of the time they were there and they were like, they finally got set up and started documenting all of the stuff, is that some days they would just go outside and there would just be a giant crater just formed in like one day. Like, they would just see some giant thing. Like, there's this one gorge called, or it's a Excelsior geyser. And it basically was just a giant crater that caved in one day.
Just out of nowhere?
Like, yeah, just out of nowhere. And then it just is now, like, a giant crater in the middle of Yellowstone.
That's crazy.
That has a pool in it and a geyser that will shoot up. It's super cool because it gets, like, if you go in, like, the cooler times, it mists up like a lot. Like a lot of the water will obviously like evaporate and mist, and it'll be like you're in like all of the mist. It's really cool.
Whoa.
Yeah. Oh, when I was there, I actually saw, if you looked into the geysers, you could kind of see into them. A couple of them actually had bones.
What?
Just in it. Yeah. Just like straight. A bone of human some like bones? Animal.
Or, okay, no,
animal is that'd be insane. I mean, maybe. To be honest, maybe, because like how would you really get it out?
Yeah. Really big hole.
Yeah, I mean, I guess you could do that. Yeah, but like, I bet there are some like human bones, like remains.
Are there railings around them today?
There aren't really. Like, there's like basically like walkways over them because I think it's like. Sort of, if you, it's too, it can't be too heavy, or it, the like entire like railing and stuff will fall in, right? So you have to be kind of careful. So it's literally just like walkways, and you have to just, you're just not allowed to leave the walkway.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's okay. A pretty hardcore place.
I'm gonna go back and build railings, and then the first explorers are gonna show up.
They're gonna take one step on it. It's gonna all cave into the. It was a trap the whole time you're setting them up.
First, you're going to wonder, like, what are these naturally occurring railings?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I would assume that they would think that maybe there was some...
Oh, like another civilization?
Yeah. That would be pretty funny, though. I think there was another thing that they did that they would see, like, the nature people. Who are they called? What are they called?
The nature people?
Yeah, the like, people who work on... in the national forest.
Oh, like park rangers.
The park rangers.
Nature people.
The nature people.
I'm saying with the druids.
Yes. The druids. So the park rangers, when they were there and they started setting up, they had a event that occurred where They were plotting out this like land of like trees where they went to this hill and there was like a bunch of trees on it. They were like, wow, that's a lot of trees. So they documented it. The next couple days or whatever, like maybe it was like a week after, they ended up going back to that same like area that they had documented that there was like, you know, it was just another forest or whatever in there. Every single tree was gone.
What?
Like vanished. They were like, what the hell happened here?
You mean they vanish?
Yeah. So apparently, the name of this hill is called Boiling Hill, which apparently what happened was is that there was like a bunch of like these trees that were on top of this like gas. It was some pocket of like really heated like underground that ended up boiling up and burning all of the trees.
What?
Yes, and they were all like disintegrated basically, and they were like are all fallen down and like burned up, and they were like, what the hell happened here? Crazy. I don't know if there's a picture of it. I need to see, but yeah, they when you go there, they have like little signs that you can read. It's really interesting. I mean, it's a smaller part of history in America, like it's not, and it's like obviously just nature or whatever, but I still feel like it's really cool just to know about that stuff.
That sounds like magic.
I know. Like, imagine, like I'm just imagining me being that park ranger who's, like, he's got to go out.
Yeah.
I'm going to go check on plot 75. He's like, all right, yep, checks out. There's trees in plot 74. All right, let's go to plot 75. He looks up and he's like, where are all the trees?
They just got up and walked away.
Yeah, they, like, I don't even know what I would think.
Did you see that when you went?
I did, yeah, I walked on it.
What is it? Like, what's it like?
Is it
a forest again?
No, I think there's some trees, but it's mostly, like, just barren, like, land. Like, I think there are some trees, there were some trees growing back and stuff, but yeah, most of it was broken up. That when I went there, there was a bison that was literally sitting like maybe like 5 feet from the walkway, and we had to walk past it.
A full-sized bison.
Yes, a full-sized wild bison.
Did it have like, was it just one?
It was just one, and it was just chilling. I think I have a picture of it.
Put up the picture. Like, Roman packs or herds?
Yeah, no, they do, but I guess sometimes they just go off on their own for a bit. There could have been some nearby, but I don't know.
Like, seeing a wild bison is kind of terrifying.
I know, yeah.
Like, any animal that could just charge you is so sketch.
Yeah, and those things are big.
Yeah.
Like, you don't understand how big they are until you actually, like, see one.
Oh, yeah, in person. I can't imagine. It's like a tank running at you.
No, and it just like, and like you just see it and you like hear it breathe, and I like you freak out, like you're like,
oh my god,
they're so cute though.
Are they?
Yeah. Yeah, they're like big cows.
Favorite president in historical times.
Man, favorite of all time.
In history.
In history. You mean like I can't pick up one that I've lived during?
Yeah, let's say before you were born.
I really like the guy who died in a tub, or did he die on the bathtub?
Is that Taft? Yeah,
that was Henry Taft.
Is it Henry Taft? That was William Taft.
Is it William? Oh no, it's William Henry Taft.
Okay, we were both right. I think you're right. I think he's your favorite.
Yeah, I mean, well, how are we rating it? Like, I think he's
no, that's fine if he's your favorite.
And I think I don't know if many people liked him, but he was a big guy, you know.
Yeah.
Like he's... I just think it's funny having just like such a big man, you know. Like, he was just obtuse.
He's like, imagine like being a president and you just become known in history as the fat president.
Yeah.
Is it like he's but he that's pretty... all I remember learning about him.
Yeah, no, me too. Like, they really didn't do much for him. I think they were just like, yeah, he really just didn't do much in the political side either. He just was kind of like a interim president, you know?
Yeah.
He didn't have much policies or anything like that.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure he did stuff, you know, but we really did not learn about Henry Tennant.
No, the only reason he was even mentioned is because he was fat.
And that he died. Well, did he die in the... Where did he... Is that something that...
I mean, I've heard that before.
It says he died from complications of heart disease and high blood pressure and inflammation of the bladder. There's no way we both remember that, you know?
Yeah, I totally... Like, it's something about him in a bathtub.
Wait, it says answer and explanation. No, William Howard Taft...
Howard.
Oh, wait, no, it wasn't Howard. Wait, it's Howard. Wait, fuck. Howard Taft did not die in a bathtub. While Taft was the president, he was the heftiest president in history, and he weighed, was recorded between 335 and 350.
Oh.
Wow. So it's a myth?
I remember something about him in a bathtub.
Yeah, or maybe he just got stuck.
Yeah, I could say, yeah, that might be it.
We thought he died. He got stuck in the bathtub, they couldn't get him out. He died because he couldn't get to any food or... Well, that kind of pushes him off of my favorite.
Oh, because he didn't die in a bathtub.
Right. Honestly, I feel like a George Bush is a pretty common answer, but...
Is that favorite?
Or not George... Yeah. Wait.
George Bush? That's also not before you were born.
George Washington. It's my Texas native blood, you know, speaking out, you know?
You literally...
I love George Bush. George Bush Jr., George Bush Sr., as long as they were born in Texas. No, George Washington.
He is a very common answer, yes. George Washington
I think,
is.
I think he was dope.
He was. I mean, he's really cool. He won the country.
He won the country. He had to train troops. Yeah. He had to train, like, other military, like, people, like, his officers and stuff.
Yeah.
He basically was, like, training everybody, bro. That's insane, like, that he was able to do that.
Yeah.
And, like, not go, like, insane, dude? Like, what the heck?
Right.
How did he do that?
And he had, like, he was scared of what, like, America was going to become after him.
Yeah. Yeah. He was like, don't even.
Like, he only took 2 terms in office.
Yeah.
Of his own accord.
He seemed like a really cool
that
guy.
He set that precedent of presidents only doing 2 terms.
And he was, like, wasn't he also against the two-party system?
Yeah, 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 yeah. He was afraid that it would divide.
Look where that got. and look where we are. I guess he was right. Who's your favorite president?
I was gonna say Lincoln.
Lincoln is a good one.
I think Lincoln is like probably the next most common answer after Washington.
Oh. Yeah, no, I think so too. I mean his like assassination thing was insane.
Yeah.
That whole plot, that was I remember that very vividly, like, yeah, at least like learning about it, because I was like, this is wild. He was just in a theater just watching a play,
yeah, and then some dude just came up and capped him.
Like, nobody was expecting that. Like, they didn't have like
secret service
back then. I mean, they probably didn't,
I guess. Yeah, probably not. I don't know how recent the Secret Service is. But Lincoln was, like, my first choice, but I was also thinking of Roosevelt.
Ooh. Yes, dude. Fucking Roosevelt. With Teddy was very big on Yellowstone. That was...
Oh, was he? Oh, right. Yeah.
That was a lot of stuff that we learned. I actually went to the arch that he was, like, took pictures in front of or something. There was, like, some arch that they had there that had a lot of stuff with, like, Roosevelt.
Yeah. That might just be because I like Night at the Museum. But
that's true, yeah. I also like how he owned a lot of really cool pets. Like, did you ever know about
No.
his list? Oh my god, let me get up his list of pets, because it's pretty insane. Okay, there's 21 of Theodore's most memorable pets. Number one and two, he had some ponies, he had horses, a herd of guinea pigs.
A herd?
Yeah. Bill the Lizard.
Oh my god.
Which I guess was a horn, he called a horn frog, very cunning, who lives in a box. I don't know what kind of, whatever. A blue macaw, that's pretty cool.
Oh, oh
man, he had a blue macaw.
Blue macaw? Okay, I think he's my favorite.
Piebald rat. He owned a rat. A snake called Spinach. That's such a cute name.
Wow.
Peter the Rabbit. A one-legged rooster.
Dude.
A Pekingese. A bull terrier. I think he also owned a bear.
What? No way. There's no way he owned a bear.
Dude, he had a bear. Wait.
No way.
He owned a few strange pets, including a black bear, a badger, a hyena, and a three-legged rooster.
What? Wait, was it one-legged or three-legged?
Wait, three-legged? Wait, what's the... why was there two... What? Three-legged rooster? How is he even a...
Did he own a bear?
I don't know. Where did he get these things
from? How did he domesticate a bear? I mean, like, I guess he could, like, own a bear, as in, like, he just has a bear at his house in, like, a cage. He basically just has a zoo at that point.
Yeah.
That is so cool that he has all those animals, though.
It was a one-legged rooster. It's not three. I don't know why they said...
Okay.
Three-legged rooster. What? They also have a picture of it, which is really cute.
Oh. Imagine being the White House, like, zookeeper.
I know. Like, he probably made it so much fun to be there, dude. That would be so sick.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, and he was also very good at it. He was very, he promoted a lot of conservation of, like, mm-hmm. nature and stuff, which I really respect that.
Isn't that, like, what the, park ranger uniform is kind of based on?
I think dressed? So, probably.
Or maybe it's the other way around, I don't know.
Yeah.
Cool. That's going to be it for us this week. Talking about American history, we covered everything in American history, just like Troy said.
We did.
We covered all of everything. Everything. that's American history. You can go ace that final now. You're welcome. Yeah,
go take that test.
Well, thanks for listening and or watching. If you want to hear more from us, please go ahead and watch the Zoot Talk episode for this week. We'll have some shrimp updates.
Don't forget about the shrimp.
We're gonna do a shrimp update, and then we're actually gonna talk about us, like, as who we are, just what, you know, it's just an introduction to us. But yeah, if you want to listen to that, you can go listen to Zoot Talk. So that's it for American history in this mission of exploring the Zoot Zone. Have a good one.
Bye, guys.
Yeah.